Treating your asphalt, cement-stabilized mud adobe, or rammed earth home requires different instructions than what one uses for burn adobe. In this video, when I use the word adobe, I'm usually referring to asphalt or cement-stabilized mud adobe that is dried or cured out in the sun. This kind of adobe is like a sponge, and because it absorbs a significant amount of water, will require a saturation rate of the silox of not more than 50 square feet per gallon or 250 square feet per 5-gallon bucket to properly protect the walls. Both rammed earth and sun-dried adobe homes and structures require similar square foot application rates. I'm basing this 50 square feet per gallon on a previously untreated home which has never been sprayed with a water repellent before. Rammed earth and stabilized sun-dried homes are like dried out, thirsty sponges and soak up an incredible amount of the silox. If your adobe or rammed earth home was treated before and treated correctly with the manufacturer's recommended coverage rate, you may be able to stretch that 50 square feet per gallon to about 80 square feet per gallon or 400 square feet per 5-gallon bucket. I understand this seems like an incredible amount of water repellent to put on your earth home, but this is unfortunately one of the unexpected and unforeseen prices one often has to pay if you want to protect this oftentimes high maintenance building material from the damaging effects of moisture penetration. Most people do not realize that adobe homes can be very high maintenance. In a couple of my other videos, I talk about a critical flood coat, which is a drenching application of the silox on your walls that is so heavy that it literally runs down the walls in long drips or legs. But this heavy and saturating flood coat is more often achieved when you spray the silox on a burn adobe home and can be more difficult to replicate on an asphalt, cement stabilized mud adobe, or rammed earth home. Burn adobe is very different than asphalt, cement stabilized mud adobe, or rammed earth. Burn adobe, usually a characteristic orangish red in color, is fired in kilns, baked, with the result that it is harder and less water absorbent than the asphalt or cement stabilized adobe or rammed earth. Because burn adobe typically absorbs less water, it requires less of the silox in order to properly treat these kind of adobes or rammed earth. On previously untreated adobe or rammed earth homes that are older than 5 or 6 years, you may not be able to put on enough of the silox to cause the drips you see in these other videos because the walls are so thirsty and suck up the silox before the water repellent has a chance to run down the walls. If you have never applied a premium water repellent like the silox before, it is critical that you closely observe the following steps. First, begin the project on a side of the home few people ever see, like the exterior of your backyard wall, if you have one. This way, you can practice on this portion of the home and get a good feel of the proper amount of silox you will need to put on, and also to see what the final result of the silox will look like on your walls. Ideally, have a nice long run of wall where there are no windows. Again, a backyard wall is an excellent place to start an experiment with. Measure out 50 square feet on this wall, and then another 50 square feet, and then another, until you have measured out 250 square feet, enough square feet for a 5-gallon bucket. If you are able, put a simple hash mark or a rock marker at each 50 square feet in the dirt along the bottom of the wall. If you are on concrete or flagstone, put a piece of blue tape on the concrete or flagstone to mark out each of the 250 square foot areas. Again, if you have never applied a water repellent to an adobe or rammed earth wall before, and you are doing this job in the middle of summer, it is critical that you begin this project in the coolest part of the day, preferably early morning when there is just enough light to easily see. The temps should be at least 60 degrees Fahrenheit and rising. If the early morning temps are significantly above 60 degrees, make sure you start spraying on walls that are in the shade and not in the full sun that have significantly heated up the walls. Pour a gallon of the Silox into your sprayer and, starting from the top of the wall, apply the entire gallon on this 50 square feet. If you find that you still have some of the Silox in this gallon after you treat the entire 50 square feet, go back and put a second coat over that 50 square feet. But you must be careful that you do not let the first coat dry before you put the second coat on. Two weather extremes you want to avoid. Spraying the Silox in cold weather, which is temperatures below 55 degrees Fahrenheit and falling. Not rising, falling. One potential problem when spraying in cold weather is that the resins in the Silox might not have a chance to absorb into the adobe, and these resins begin to cure while sitting on the surface of the walls instead of being totally absorbed. This can leave a permanent whitish or bluish-white coating on the surface of the adobe that will not disappear, even when the weather warms up. The second weather extreme to guard against is treating walls that are too hot, because the Silox can flash dry, meaning the walls are so hot that as soon as a Silox hits the walls, it almost instantly dries before having a chance to absorb into the adobe. If your walls are so hot that you can't rest your hand on them for several seconds without feeling as if you are going to burn your palm, wait until the walls cool down. In hot summers where the temps are past 90 or 95 degrees Fahrenheit, always spray the walls when they are in the shade. Start on the west or south side of the house first thing in the morning so you can spray these walls in the early morning shade, moving around to the east and north walls as the day progresses, ensuring that you are always spraying the walls while they are shaded. And it goes without saying that applying the Silox in a heavy rain, or if a heavy rain is expected within 48 to 72 hours after you finish the walls, is never a good idea. It takes approximately 72 hours for the resins in the Silox to completely cure, and you want to avoid any moisture being introduced into the walls during this time frame. Ideally, you should really have a helper. I always work with at least one other experienced person. The helper's job is critical. He is the runner, responsible for making sure I, the spray man, never run out of the Silox. Most of the burnt adobe homes we treated with the Silox were large, requiring an average 25 to 35 gallons, 5 to 6 gallon buckets. When we treated asphalt stabilized mud adobe homes, the amount of product we used was greater. Rammed earth homes require just as much of the Silox as asphalt or cement stabilized ones. The runner will always ensure there is more Silox right near me as I begin to run dry. If I had to stop, take off my backpack sprayer, go halfway around the house to retrieve another bucket of the Silox, and take the time to open it, stir it, and pour it into another empty 5-gallon bucket to make it easier to pour into my backpack sprayer, this would risk the Silox that I had already applied on the walls drying before I had a chance to put additional product on the walls if I needed to put a second coat on them. The runner is also responsible for the all-important job of running a hose and making sure all excess Silox that has pooled down at the bottom of the walls is diluted and washed away and rinsed off of plants or anything else that should not be coated with the Silox. Garage doors, outdoor furniture, gates, pet bowls, etc. I've sealed houses by myself early in my career, and trust me, find yourself a helper. If you've only purchased a small amount of the Silox, say 1 or 2 5-gallon buckets, you should be able to handle this size project on your own. But even this small job is not easy. You still have all the watering and masking of windows to do, and this is always better done with someone helping you in a coordinated manner. If you are using a 4 or 5-gallon backpack sprayer to do your home, though you can also use an airless sprayer, A helper comes in handy because they can lift the full backpack up to your back while you put your arms through the straps. Putting on a full or even partially filled 5-gallon backpack sprayer on by yourself is not easy and can even be dangerous. For your convenience, I sell an inexpensive 4-gallon backpack sprayer that works great. When you are sealing a wall, you must finish that entire wall. For example, let's say you are sealing a 30-foot long, 14-foot high wall. After sealing the first 20 feet, when you are only halfway down the wall, you completely run out of product. You miscalculated how much you needed to buy and you are out. This is a problem for at least two reasons. First, if you have managed to achieve a flood coat where there are any runs, these runs or drips will dry, and once you get more Siloxx and continue on this wall, these drips will show through. In other words, you will, in certain light, always be able to see these drips. Second, in certain light, you might see what I call the hard edge, the line where you stopped the first coat, the point where you ran out of the Siloxx, and began the next section days or weeks later when you were able to get more product. You won't be able to fix this. This is why you always finish whatever wall you begin to avoid these two problems. Since we live in the real world where mistakes always happen, here is how to solve this problem if you are faced with it. With your water hose, gently rinse off this hard edge of sealer and or the drips. Don't overdo it and completely wash all the Siloxx away, but dilute it down before it has a chance to dry so that the Siloxx does not end up drying at full strength. This way, by diluting and gently rinsing most of the Siloxx away while it is still wet, when you hit this wall with the Siloxx after you purchase more, these drips and the hard edge won't be seen. I always put a second mist or fog coat on my customers' homes, which is just a quick, light fog coat over all the areas I just sprayed, done just in case I may have missed a spot. Is this absolutely necessary? Not if you made certain you put enough on the walls with the flood coat. Again, I always did it to my customers' homes and never once had a callback in approximately 30 years of a problem with a failure in the spraying of the Siloxx on their walls. Not once. It was good insurance and made me feel that I went the extra step for my customers. Please follow common sense personal protection protocols when spraying the Siloxx. Don't breathe, drink, or bathe in it, nor allow pets to do so. Though water-based and not inherently dangerous to use like an oil-based product, nevertheless, it contains chemicals that might cause adverse reactions for those with certain skin and eye sensitivities or allergies. Wear eye protection, filter masks, the same as you would wear for COVID-19 protection. Completely cover your skin with long-sleeved shirts, pants, work boots, gloves, etc. Wearing an old, broad-brimmed hat is great for keeping the Siloxx out of your eyes while spraying overhead. If you do happen to get the Siloxx on your skin, wash it off as soon as possible. If splashed in your eyes, immediately and thoroughly rinse them out with cool water. Seek medical attention if you experience any long-term and adverse skin or eye reactions. Thoroughly protect yourself and you won't have any problems. Finally, watch out for drips. Always follow any drips all the way down to the bottom of the wall with additional Siloxx. In other words, don't allow drips to dry on your walls without having those drips drenched in additional Siloxx. There is a danger of those drips, if allowed to dry by themselves, to stain the walls. Please watch my other videos posted on my website for additional helpful insider tips for properly treating your earth home. Best of success with your project.